I saw the Statue of Liberty, and I stood at the railing, and you look at it.
How did it make you
look
feel?
At it, and you see the Manhattan traffic and the lights, and the Manhattan skyscrapers. Then we came to Hoboken, and I had been given a citation by General Eisenhower about my work with the saving pilots and things, and the custom guy opened our file, and he saw the citation right on top of the file, and he looked up, and he spoke my favorite words. Ah, she's supposed to control this kind of thing. He said, welcome to America. That was it. I was now in the United States. And 5 years later, I became a citizen, a proud nationalized citizen who wish we could solve the immigration law of today's world, which is utopia. Then we lived in New York, and I had decided on a profession. Although I took a job in an office, shipping office, that groomed people like me to become an international sales, a very big outfit. The director had been a Berliner, and some of his executives were former immigrants. And when, wonderful.
When did you arrive? What was the date that you arrived in America, in New York?
4th of March, 1947. And I took this office job, but I took training in what I wanted to really do. And 2 years later, when I thought I was ready to audition and had picked up little non-professional pieces in theater or something like that.
How did you decide upon this profession?
I decided in during the occupation in Germany. I couldn't see myself in a 9-to-5 job, and I became, as the liaison man, I helped establish the theater for the troops in Flensburg.
Oh, tell me about that.
No, it's a very simple story. The Americans had the USO, and the British had the ENSA, entertainment stuff. And once the occupation started, the military government detachment was ordered to set up a theater for the ENSA. And the ENSA people came in, and I was the liaison with the Germans and the things. And a sergeant who had run a theater in England came and was in charge of the ENSA theater. I thought, this is what I would like to do. I'd always been interested in drama and reading and poetry and singing. Even at the Goldschmidt Schule was a wonderful professor who allowed me to participate in drama readings and things.